A plan has just been approved to give pay raises to state college presidents, and it's coming under fire. Eyewitness News reporter Robert Olguin is live now in Long Beach, where the Cal State University Board of Trustees approved the pay hike for some of the leaders at these financially strapped colleges. Robert.
Yeah, initially this two-day meeting that just wrapped up today, the focus was to be on how to deal with a $750 million budget shortfall. One proposal was to limit enrollment for the spring semester, but no final decision was made on that proposal. Instead, two pay raises were handed out, and that didn't sit well with students who've had to deal with tuition increases. It might seem counterintuitive to give pay raises to the presidents of two Cal State campuses during a budget crisis, but Cal State officials did exactly that this afternoon, arguing that the new presidents of Cal State Fullerton and Cal State East Bay deserve a raise. Each will now be paid about $300,000 annually.
All in favor?
Aye.
The 11-3 vote in favor of the pay raises was made at the Board of Trustees meeting in Long Beach this afternoon. CSU officials say that presidents in the Cal State system make 20% less than presidents at other universities. But that didn't mean much to angry students who came to protest the pay raises.
I can only dream of finding a job after I graduate in May where I'll make 15% of what some of you presidents and what the chancellor is making this year. This is not easy for the majority of students to handle. I've worked 60-hour weeks to pay for my education while covering 17 units so I could get a degree that would allow me to be able to contribute to society, as I'm told I'm supposed to do.
The Cal State president's salaries make up $7 million of the roughly $2 billion budget in the CSU system. Governor Jerry Brown voiced his disapproval with the board's decision.
The colleges, and not just those, but a lot of public employers think that they have to give pay raises that I don't think so, because the average person has not gotten a pay raise, and the kids have been paying more in tuition.
Trustees today also grappled with how to deal with a $750 million budget shortfall. Also at issue, the governor's tax initiative. If it fails in November, it would trigger an additional $200 million budget cut for the Cal State system.
Criticism of this board, the chancellor, presidents, and others has been dramatically misdirected. We are all functioning in unprecedented circumstances related to a lack of funding and an outright policy of disinvesting in public higher education.
The university presidents that got the pay raises will be making about 10% more than their predecessors. And again, that proposal to limit enrollment on 23 campuses next spring, that is still under consideration. No final vote was made here this afternoon. Reporting live from Long Beach, Robert Olguin, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
Robert, thank you.